I was a pudgy, brace-faced, short-haired tomboy, so safe to say I was no one's first choice.
Damn! Damn, girl. Little Lauren, I'm so sorry. Wow. I made this video almost 6.5 years ago. July 15th, 2014, I uploaded my Draw My Life video. And I honestly have not watched it, probably for almost all of that 6.5 years. Not because I don't like the video, but this is one of those videos that if somebody else is watching it, I can't watch it with them. I feel really uncomfortable. And I don't know, anxious, I don't know what it is. Any personal videos about myself, I cannot watch with another person. It's just too weird. Now I got this idea because my good friend Gloom also reacted to her Draw My Life after 5 years. And she said the same exact thing. Like, this is one of those videos she just can't watch with another person. And I feel you. So yeah, I'm gonna watch this for the first time in like 6 years, basically. I figured this was the perfect time to finally look back at my Draw My Life because now that I'm pregnant, my life is gonna be changing a lot after the baby comes. And my pregnancy announcement video blew up and ended up on trending, like number one and number two for 2 days. So I have a lot of new people, hello, that may not know much about me and my life, so I figured this was perfect. And some background of this video before I started. It was a 25,000 sub special. Yes, I only had 25,000 subscribers when I made this. And what's funny is I wanted to save it for 100,000 subscribers, but I thought I would never get there. So I was like, you know what? Let's just do it at the next milestone in case this is my only chance to have a reason to do it. Here we are 6.5 years later and things have changed. Just a little bit. But this was also one of the first videos that I made that like my family understood and liked and appreciated. Up until this point, they knew I did YouTube. It was just a hobby, it was just for fun. They didn't get like the gaming part of it. They still don't really. But when they saw this video, they were like, oh my God, they shared it with everybody. This was the first time I remember my family being very excited about a video that I had made on YouTube, which is pretty cool. But this was filmed while Bobby and I were just dating. We had just moved out of the city into an apartment and it took me all weekend to film because I was still working my regular job. So I could only film it on the weekend. It literally took me 2 days to film. So yeah, that's the background. And here we go.
Hey guys, it's Lauren. And today
I sound like such a little kid.
Draw My Life video. You guys have been so supportive and so awesome that I felt it only right to do it for you guys to celebrate me hitting 25,000 subscribers.
Woo!
Well, now it's 26 already. It's going so fast.
I love that I had to add that in. I was like, well, actually it's 26. It's not 25. I think at this point I really didn't share like anything personal on the internet about my actual life. So this is a big deal for me. Also, I can't believe how little I sound and how like timid my voice is on the camera. And you guys are still awesome and supportive, so that didn't change.
I was born on July 7th, AKA the day the world became amazing.
Okay, people made fun of me for this all the time because it looked like I put myself in a straitjacket, which fair, I mean, sure.
I was born into a family which already consisted of my mom, dad, and my older sister, Chrissy. 2 years later, my younger brother, Ryan, was born and our family was complete. My older sister, Chrissy, is actually my half-sister, so she mainly lived with her mom in Pennsylvania, but would visit us a lot. And I remember every time that she would have to leave me, I would cry.
So fun fact, when I filmed this, she didn't have one, but my sister also has a YouTube channel too. I'll put it in the description. But this is still the same, we're still close.
After I was born, my family moved to our house in upstate New York, and we still have that house today.
Oh, no, we don't! Wait, what did I say?
Really one of my favorite places in the world.
It's my happiest place in the world and we still have it. We don't anymore. Yeah, sadly, my childhood home was sold. My mom ended up moving to Florida where she is very happy and has a much smaller and more manageable house now that she doesn't have us kids living with her anymore. So it made sense, but it's still sad.
I was even lucky enough to be in a house across the street from another little girl who was the same age as me. Her name was Sarah, and we became BFFs.
Fun fact, after my pregnancy announcement, Sarah actually reached out, we started talking again, so that's pretty cool. Pretty funny timing.
We did everything together, but we were total opposites. I was more of a tomboy and not really caring so much about my appearance
Still.
And loved playing video games.
Still.
In third grade, my parents sent me to Catholic school because they believed I was evil. Just kidding.
I hate the laugh. Just kidding. Oh, little Lauren.
I started liking boys around this time too, but I was a pudgy, brace-faced, short-haired tomboy, so safe to say I was no one's first choice.
Damn! I didn't realize how hard I went on myself. This is so sad. Damn, girl. Little Lauren, I'm so sorry. And for anybody who doesn't know, there's a lot more personal videos over the past 6 years that I put out. I will link like the playlist for all my personal videos in the description below too, if you're interested or new. But for anybody that asks, yes, I did go to Catholic school. I was raised Catholic, but I'm not a practicing Catholic. As of now. So I'm not like a religious person or anything, just because I know I'm gonna get questions about it, because I do.
When it was time to graduate from Catholic school, Sarah and I decided to go to the public high school over the Catholic alternative to get a fresh start and get away from the other kids. It ended up being a really good decision because I made a ton of friends who helped me to experience new things that I had never had before.
Okay, I feel like I need to address this. I feel like my family is gonna rewatch my reaction to this. So I felt bad after I put this in because I didn't explain fully, but my mom wrote me and was like, I'm sorry, I didn't know you hated the Catholic school that much. I thought we were making a good decision for you. We more so left because of the kids there. The majority of the kids there were terrible. Like they weren't very I mean, I feel like a lot of schools might be like that, but we were literally stuck with the same kids. And if we decided to go to a Catholic high school, we would have been stuck with the same kids again. And I was like, I'm not doing this my whole high school life. Also, because you had the same kids, you all knew everything about one another from like the time you were in third grade. So I wanted like a new start with new people. And I will say, because when you're raised in like a Catholic school with the same people, you're not really like learning or experiencing anything new about new, because you're not meeting new people. That's all that I meant. I meant that I went to a public high school where there was a lot more kids from a lot more different backgrounds, a lot more different religions, financial situations, what have you. So I ended up learning a bit more. I'm sure I would have been fine at the other school too, but I am happy that I decided to leave all those kids and go to this one. And actually a lot of the Catholic school kids ended up transferring to the public school because they ended up having problems with some of the kids at the Catholic school. So yeah, it's mainly that. Don't worry, Mom, you did a great job. I'm doing great and I love you.
I even started wearing makeup and dressing nicer, but I never gave up my love of so-called boy activities like playing video games, snowboarding, and imitating the show Jackass.
You know what's crazy? All of those activities now are not like, I mean, I guess there's still a stigma about competitive gaming. I feel like now girls do those activities and it's not really a big deal. I feel like when I was growing up, it was a big deal. It was so cool. And I felt cool. So it's like, I'm a girl and I do these things and nobody else does them. And now everybody does them. So it's like, now it's more of a stigma of like, competitive, like more guys are in competitive gaming, more guys are in competitive snowboarding, and it's cool to see the shift, is what I'm saying. It's cool to see the shift from then till now, and I feel like that's why I ended up growing so much on YouTube, because where I used to have this little niche audience of people who related to me, because they were also girls who like these things and not many people like them, it grew to like all these people liking the same things and relating to me and also wanting in on the community, which is awesome, but did not expect that to happen.
Eventually, Sarah found a new group of friends who had more in common with her, and eventually our close friendship faded from there. However, we still keep in touch, and she still lives across the street from my family home.
That's not true either anymore. She moved away. She moved to the south. So much has changed.
I ended up making two really great friends in high school named Michelle and Kayla, and a whole bunch of other friends, so I wasn't alone.
So it's funny, Kayla and me still follow each other on like Facebook and stuff, but we don't really like talk a lot. I know she moved away too, but me and Michelle, I actually just saw her a couple weeks ago, and she just had her first baby, and we're still really close, so that's good. So sometimes your high school friends do stick around.
When I started my second year of high school, my dad told us he had lung cancer.
Oh no.
I remember not being too worried about it at the time because one, I was young and optimistic, and two, he was in such high spirits saying that the doctor said because he was still young that his body could beat it. Even through the chemo, the hair loss, and the pain, my dad never lost his humor or his bright spirit, and he will always be my hero for that. On a cold October morning when I was 15, I was pulled out of class by my mom, who told me that my dad had passed away.
This is probably my least favorite part to rewatch. It's just for obvious reasons.
Obviously, I went through a really dark period after that day. I fell into a really, really bad depression, and I really didn't feel like myself anymore.
What's crazy, since this Draw My Life came out, I know some of you know, because I talked about it, but my stepdad, my mom's husband, also got diagnosed with cancer last year, and I couldn't believe that it was happening all over again to our family. But luckily, I feel like since, this all happened in 2004. We're now I don't know why I looked at the date. I know it's 2020. Of course this is 2020. But I feel like even in that amount of time, cancer treatments, while still, cancer's still very serious and doesn't always have a great outcome. But I feel like the more I've learned about it from this second stint of it with our family, they have come so far with cancer treatment. It's crazy. I'm hoping I live in a world one day when I'm older that cancer can be, for the most part, cured. And happy ending to that story. So far, my stepdad went into remission and is looking pretty clear. So fingers crossed that it stays that way and we're all good.
If there was any good to come out of something so horrible that happened to us, it was that me and my mom and my brother became so close.
Filmed on a different day. Okay, the other part of this, I feel like I'm just addressing comments that my family has made after watching this video back in the day. My sister was like, what about me? I didn't mean that we weren't also close. We were always close. I would see my sister every other weekend. So my regular day-to-day family life used to be my mom, dad, me, and my brother. So I meant more so our day-to-day life, because we had this emptiness. He used to be there every day, so it was just the three of us. That's what I meant. Not that we were any less close. Yeah, filmed on a different day because it's
always
more
there,
yellow.
Telling really weird and funny jokes to try and make me smile. But just like my dad, my mom is such a hero to me for the way that she dealt with such a horrible situation.
And she even started seeing someone who eventually became my stepdad, and we all loved that he made her happy again. By the last year of high school, I was finally starting to resurface as the person I was before my dad died. This is where YouTube first came into play.
Yay.
Like I mentioned before, I always had a love of making videos. So in 2007, 2 years after YouTube began, I created the account Laurenside. It stood for Laurenside of the Story, and it was where I would post random camera ramblings.
For everyone that asks.
I went to college upstate for a year and a half, and while it was a blast and I made a lot of friends, I felt like something was missing. So I made the hard decision to say goodbye to my college friends and head to New York City. Meanwhile, I also got the urge to lose weight. I was never fat, but I was the chubbiest girl usually out of all of my friends.
True story.
So during my transition from upstate New York to New York City, I lost close to 40 pounds and have kept that weight off ever since.
That's still true. Well, until now, because it's not my fault, because I'm pregnant. But yeah, 6.5 years late, I mean, I've fluctuated for sure, but for the most part have kept a healthy weight all the way since then, so.
Yay, me.
Moving to New York City is without a doubt the best decision I've made in my life so far.
What the heck is this? I just noticed that. I was like, what did I just draw back here? Okay, Lauren.
Honestly, being young and in the city is one unforgettable experience.
Still true. But when you get older, it's really annoying to live and work there. That's why we don't live there anymore. We just like to visit, but now we can't because, oh my God, so much has changed since this. So much has changed. Lauren, from 2014, I wish I could tell you. I could warn you. Not like you could do anything, but visit New York City more because you won't be able to for an entire year and a half.
I graduated in the highest GPA tier. I worked as an intern, sometimes for 19-hour days during events, and I also worked a part-time job. I felt like Superwoman.
I like how when I was younger, I was like, I was fat, brace-faced, pudgy, nobody liked me. And now I'm like, I graduated in the highest honors, and I worked my butt off, and I was a Superwoman. I mean, at least it came back around. It came back around. We love a girl with confidence.
One semester into school at New York City, my boyfriend from back home and I broke up. Although I really cared about him, I learned that there's a fine line between someone who loves you and someone who tries to hold you back. I constantly felt stressed and anxious that one of my guy friends would post to my Facebook wall because it would usually upset my boyfriend. Sometimes love isn't enough, and you need to find someone who loves you and trusts you enough to do things like go out with your friends and not text them every minute all night.
Wow, Lauren dropping some romantic advice knowledge. I mean, still true, still holds true. You should follow that. Yeah, my view on that hasn't changed much. I'm a big believer of, especially if you're somebody like me who has really bad anxiety in the world, like mine's so much better in the past couple years. No medication, no nothing, just like working at learning how to have a better perspective and better management exercises, things that you can do to try and like ease your anxiety and make you feel more centered. I know this sounds very hippie-ish, but yeah, I'm a big believer, especially if you're somebody like me, whoever you end up wanting to marry, like date whoever you want, learn things about them and yourself along the way. I think it's really important. But whoever you decide to marry needs to be like a home base for you. If you find that you're going and being with this person, even though you love them or might love them or think that you love them, if every time you go to see them, you have more anxiety and you fight and you, it's not like a home base, it's not a safe place for you, it's probably not good for forever. So my thoughts on that still haven't changed. Hopefully if you're like, yeah, every time I see my boyfriend or girlfriend, they just cause me a lot of anxiety and stress for the majority of the time I'm with them. Yeah, it's probably not good. It's probably not good. You either gotta find a way to work it out or you guys might just not be right for each other. Because forever is a really long time.
Right before I graduated from college, I began dating my now boyfriend, Bobby. We had been interns together and became friends. We eventually started dating and we've been together ever since. Bobby is the total opposite of my last relationship and it has strengthened me as a person. I truly believe you should find someone who helps you to be the best version of yourself, and that's our relationship.
Didn't even know. We were still just dating in this. We've come so far in 6.5 years.
Bobby and I started renting an apartment together, and eventually we got Dexter.
Dexter!
I finally felt like I had almost everything in my life together for once. But I still felt like something was missing. Here's where YouTube comes into play.
Oh, I was like, did I? What happened now?
I had recently started finding game commentators, which I had no idea even existed.
Oh my god, who do I write?
The first person I found was PewDiePie, and I became addicted to watching his videos because they made me laugh so much.
What? Oh no, okay. PewDiePie is still a big name, loved him. I has Cupquake, I'm pretty sure I had never even talked to Tiff at this point, and like, last year, I went over her house to hang out with her. Like, things are crazy. Things have changed drastically since then. Venjelf, I don't know if she makes videos anymore. I haven't seen her around the internets in a while. I think she came back for a little bit. I don't know if she's gone. I don't know. But wow, Venjelf. This is a name from the past. Markiplier, okay, he's still around.
I decided to reboot my old Laurenside username and became addicted to making videos again.
Addicted.
Since I started my channel a year and a half ago, I have grown more than I ever thought I would. I know you guys always tell me how much I help brighten your day, but I just wanted to remind you guys how much you help me to be happier in my life too.
Ditto.
And also, if you haven't already, that you know a big chunk about me and my life, why don't you hit the subscribe button?
Yeah, why don't you do that now too? I don't even have to say it later. Like the video. Thank you, past Lauren. 6.5 years ago, Lauren. Comments, yes, still love comments. It's still a thing. Could you imagine I was like, we don't do likes anymore. Aw, and that was my Draw My Life from 6.5 years ago. I have been contemplating for a long time doing a new one, but I can't decide if I want to pick up from where this left off or if I want to go back through everything to make like one long, maybe more digital drawing of a Draw My Life so that it's more, I don't know, it has everything in it and it's a little more updated. I feel like on this one, I tried to focus on a lot more of my like childhood memories and things because I thought that was more relatable to people. So I did leave a lot out, but I tried to hit on like the biggest things. But also it's been 6.5 years since I made this. So like, I don't know, what haven't I talked about? Getting engaged, getting married. Now we're having a baby. Still have Dexter. We had 2 houses since then. We moved into our first house when YouTube was still a hobby. Outgrew that house when YouTube became a full-time job and we needed like workspace in our house to do it. Got this one. I went from having, I think I still had my first job when I was making this and I soon after making this got into my basketball job that I had right before I started doing YouTube full-time, which also changed a lot. So yeah, I'm trying to decide if I wanna do that or I could do a Draw My Life about like Bobby and my relationship because there's so many details of that. I don't know. If you guys want to see that stuff, make sure for sure to leave a like so I can tell if I should do a new updated one or a love story one. Like and leave a comment below letting me know. But this was really fun. Thanks so much for reliving the memories with me. And if you've been here since I released this video, thank you so much to all the 26,000 of you. Probably nowhere near that that's still here, but I appreciate you. And if you still want to learn more about me, here's two more of the personal videos that I was talking about. Click one of them. If you've seen these, I will leave a link in the description to all of them. And as always, I will see you guys soon.